So first Bohemian Rhapsody and now Ballroom Blitz as the trailer music. Boy, David Ayer must be one really big fan of Wayne's World. So the new Suicide Squad trailer debuted last night at the MTV Movie Awards, and Suicide Squad is probably the movie that I'm looking forward to the most for the rest of the year, with the exception of Jungle Book, which comes out this week. And that is largely due to how well the marketing for this movie has been so far. I first saw the Comic-Con trailer that had been leaked, and I thought, okay, it's any other DC trailer, it's dark and grim, big surprise there. But I still enjoyed it due to the operatic, soundtrack that the trailer had. I liked a couple of the action set pieces, like Deadshot swinging down a building. But what really hooked me was the introduction of Jared Leto as the Joker. And man, was that creepy. Then the official trailer came out, and ever since I first saw it, I have never been able to stop listening to Bohemian Rhapsody. I just love this trailer so much. I mean, the unconventional song fit the unpredictable nature of villains acting like heroes really well. The action was a lot of fun. We got to see some of the characters interacting with each other. The dark sense of humor was funny, especially with Harley Quinn. We got to see a little bit more of the Joker. And what I enjoyed the most about that trailer was we didn't actually see what the actual plot was, so nothing was spoiled for us, which is pretty rare for a trailer. And after seeing this new Blitz trailer, it felt a little bit more like a promo that you would see on TV. There's a little more quick banter between some of the characters, you see a little bit more of the action scenes. It doesn't really give away anything plot-wise or character-wise in terms of depth or backstory. And while it isn't anywhere as near as awesome as the official trailer, I gotta say, this was still a lot of fun to watch. I thought that it was pretty cool that we were starting to see a little bit more of the characters interacting with each other. You're starting to see a little bit more of their personalities, and you're wondering how they're gonna function together as a team, like when Deadshot pressures El Diablo into unleashing his powers for a mission. We see a tiny glimpse of June Moon being possessed before she becomes the Enchantress. We see a little bit more of Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn being revealed in this trailer, and oh. Sorry. But yeah, I thought Harley Quinn looked a lot cooler in this trailer. I smiled so wide when I saw her carrying her mallet, because I was just convinced that she was going to carry around that bat for the rest of the movie, and that's not nearly as cool as her hammer, which we see in the cartoon and in the comics. And man, am I so excited to see Jared Leto as the Joker. I've heard all the complaints. I don't care what he's wearing, whether he has tattoos or replacement teeth or whatever. Because in all honesty, I still think he looks like a legitimate creepy threat, and I'm just dying to know what he's gonna do in this movie because we're still not entirely sure. My only real concern is that his laugh doesn't sound as menacing as someone like Nicholson or Ledger. But you know, the movie's not finished, and maybe they're saving like his best laugh for the rest of the movie, or maybe even for a different one, so who knows. And based on what I've seen in these trailers, I am really excited to see how David Ayer handles the action scenes in this movie. It isn't just Deadshot shooting these weird people in animal costumes. You got to see cars crashing, you got to see a helicopter fall out of the sky. You got to see people like Katana or Captain Boomerang or El Diablo getting into the action. And here's the awesome part for me. You can actually see everything. There's no shaky cam, there's no over-editing, at least none that I saw. It just looks so seamless and so well shot. And like most comic book movie trailers, there are moments where if you blink, you miss a ton of information. For me, one thing that caught my mind was there's this one scene where Harley, probably back when she was a psychiatrist, was falling off a ledge in a building. And the only reason that caught my attention was because in the official trailer, we saw Joker diving off a ledge of a building into a pool of green liquid, and he pulled out Harley. And that's when I started to wonder, wow, is that how they got their pale skin? Is that what turned her insane? But I'm sure what surprised a lot of you, and myself included, the most, was seeing Batman diving into a lake, pulling out an unconscious Harley and taking her to the Batmobile. And if you've seen Batman v Superman, you already know that this Batman does not play nice. Whether or not he's gonna torture her, or whether he's gonna lure the Joker with her as bait, Whatever happens, I hope it ties into the movie itself and not really as an Easter egg for another solo movie or something like that, but either way, it still looks really interesting. My only real complaint with this trailer is this moment where Will Smith goes, "Just remember, we're the bad guys." And yeah, at this point it's getting a little bit old to point out that these are the bad guys acting as heroes. I know this is new for a comic book movie, but still, a friend of mine pointed out that there are many shows and different animes where this concept isn't really as original as David Ayer or any other of the producers seem to think it is. So it's getting a little old saying, "Hey, we're bad guys being good guys," and I'm just like, yeah, we know. You can stop pointing it out. Well, those were my thoughts on the Suicide Squad trailer. What were your thoughts? Please let me know in the comments below. Be sure to like, subscribe, follow me on Twitter, Facebook, whatever, if you can. Take care.